Hi there, this is Imaneo, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about an exception or an error that I saw in my Crashlytics for the Save the Potato game. It says libflutter.so not found. So I think this is a common issue this is a common exception. That's why I decided to record a video and talk about the steps that I went through to fix it, and also at the end I will introduce you the solution to fix the issue. In the first step, we need to take a look at the details of the error. It says unable to start activity and unsatisfied link error, and it says libflutter.so not found. So as you see, the app is not working in some devices, and probably when you open the app, it closes immediately because libflutter.so is not exist and it is a crucial file to run the app. Okay, at first, let's talk about the SO files. So these are some C++ codes that are compiled into a single file. For example, when you compile your Flutter application, it compiles everything such as Eskia, Flutter engine, and anything that it has into a single file, and it puts the SO file inside the APK file that is going to be installed on the user device in Android case. The point is that in Android, we have different kind of CPU architectures, and they work with different instructions, and that's why Flutter needs to generate some SO files based on the architecture types that Android supports. For example, we have V7, we have V8, and we have x86-64, and also we have x86. So these are the CPU architectures that are supported by Android. And when you want to work with Android NDK, you have to build your SO files and put them inside the APK file or app bundle to allow the user to install the app. Okay, now let's get back to the error. Yeah, it says that this error or exception happened on 1.0.1 version. So I'm going to open the Save the Potato repository. If you don't know what is the Save the Potato game, you can take a look at these videos in the repository readme. And yeah, so here we have releases, and in the 1.0.1 release, we have release files. Here we have the AAB file for 1.0.1. And I'm going to show you a method to see the content of this app bundle file. So then we can take a look at the architecture types and what we have inside them to see the SO files. So here I have an Android Studio, and you only need to drag drop the AAB file inside your Android Studio. Yes, here you see the detail of your app bundle. You can check the size that your resources is using or other things. Yeah, for example, here it says that lib directory is the largest directory that we have. It is around 60 megabytes, and inside that you see different CPU architectures that Android supports. So here we have x86-64, here we have ARM V8, and here we have ARM V7. Also we have x86. So as you see, we have different SO files. This is the Flutter one, libflutter.so. And because in my game I use Rive, Rive also creates some SO files here. And I'm not sure about the other one. Maybe this is for Flutter, I'm not sure. And the point is that when you take a look at x86 directory, you only see the Rive SO file. So Flutter doesn't exist here. And when you take a look at the Flutter supported ABIs or architectures, it says that Flutter apps can be compiled for V7, V8, and x86-64. Flutter supports building for x86 Android through ARM emulation. So it says that Flutter doesn't generate SO file for x86 because it is kind of old and it uses an ARM version to emulate it and run the Flutter app in x86 Android. So that's why normally you don't see this x86 directory, you only see these three architectures, but because we added Rive, it generated a new directory called x86 and it put the libRive inside that. And the point is that when you install the APK in an x86 mobile or CPU architecture, it sees that, okay, we have a directory, we don't need to emulate anything or simulate anything, we just need to grab the SO files and work with that. And when you run the app, it tries to find the libflutter.so because you generated the directory. When it tries to find the libflutter.so inside that, it sees that there is no Flutter SO file here, so app crashes. The point is that we don't need to generate the, this directory because Flutter is not able to generate that. It just generates these three architectures, and the devices that work with x86 architecture uses one of these ARM SO files to emulate them and work with that. So to fix that, we need to somehow remove this directory because Flutter doesn't support that. Okay, wait a minute. If you like this kind of content, I mean, when I talk about the detail of something or when I dig into the detail of a concept, please let me know by your comment. You can write your feedback in the comments. Then I can decide to have more videos like this in the future. Also, don't forget to subscribe the channel. Okay, so we know the issue and the solution is to remove this directory because Flutter doesn't support x86 and somehow we need to remove this from the final result. So this way, x86 devices, when they open the APK file, they see that, okay, we don't have any x86 SO file, so we are going to use an ARM version to emulate the instructions. So when I searched it, I saw this solution inside the Flutter GitHub. I will put a link into the description. And it says that you need to write this command or this code in the build.gradle file, your app build.gradle file. So this way you restrict the app to only generate these ABI filters or ABI directories. So I'm going to copy paste this code and I'm going to open the build.gradle in the Android. Yes, and to make sure that we are touching the correct one. Yeah, this was not correct. This is the correct one because it is inside the app. And here we have a default config. As you see, in the default config, we need to copy paste this part. And it says, okay, we need to have ARM V8, ARM V7, and also x86-64. Okay, and when I run Flutter build app bundle, we have to wait a little to have the result. Okay, here we have our new app bundle file, and because we are in the Android directory, we need to open it from the parent directory. So I'm going to say open this directory. And yeah, so I'm going to drag drop this file into the Android Studio and compare it with the other one in the base lib. Yes, as you see, we only have these three main architectures that Flutter supports. We don't have the directory for x86 that we had before that. So this way, when you install the app in an x86 device or CPU architecture, it uses the other directories to emulate the functionality. So this way we fix the issue. Okay, I think we are done. So you only need to add this part inside your build.gradle file that is inside the app directory. After that, your app bundle is going to generate only these three main architectures that you have. Again, please write me your feedback about this kind of content when I talk about the details. And thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.